हेलो। सो फार वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद द सिलेबस ऑफ फ्लूड मैकेनिक्स, वेयर वी हैव सीन द कंटेंट व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन द फ्लूड मैकेनिक्स कोर्स। एंड द फर्स्ट लेक्चर दैट वी टूक ऑन द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ फ्लूड मैकेनिक्स, एंड इन दैट व्हाट इज़ फ्लूइड, व्हाट इज़ द डिफरेंस बिटवीन फ्लूइड, सॉलिड एंड गैस, अलॉन्ग विद दिस हाउ द फ्लूइड कैन बी डिफाइंड। So based on this, we have defined the fluid as a substance which deforms continuously under the action of any amount of shear stress or shear force. And then after we have seen the concept of continuum, which is required for the study of fluid mechanics. Now in the second lecture, we are going to cover the concept of viscosity. So we are going to learn the concept of viscosity over here in this lecture. So viscosity is also known as dynamic viscosity or absolute viscosity. In general, in day-to-day life, viscosity refers to the degree of thickness of a fluid. So in that, if the liquid is thinner, we call this as a thin liquid, and if the liquid is thicker, we call this as a thick liquid. The best examples for this are the syrup, liquid syrup that we make using a sugar or using any kind of solid dissolved in a liquid, or the liquid itself like water or the oil. They are all are having different viscosities, and because of this you can say that the syrups flow at slow rate, and while the water or the oil or the glycerin or any kind of liquid like petrol, diesel can flow at more speed than that of the syrups. Or you can take an example of a toothpaste that is coming out from the pack. If you apply a shear, it comes at very less velocity. The tomato ketchups also have different viscosity. They are thicker, and based on this, we say thicker and thinner liquids. And the technical term that is used for defining this viscosity is dynamic viscosity or absolute viscosity or viscosity. So basically, viscosity is a property of fluid. It is because of cohesion, and it offers a resistance to shear deformation. So it offers a resistance, means it offers a resistance to a flow of a liquid. And there are different fluids which deforms at different rates under the same shear. Means if you apply a small force on the toothpaste, the whatever the rate at which the toothpaste will come out from the from the packet, and if you apply the same shear force on a water, the water flow rate would be more. And fluids with high viscosity, such as syrup, paint, deforms more slowly than fluid with a low viscosity, such as water and glycerin. The unit for the viscosity is Newton second per meter square, or as this Newton per meter square is nothing but a pressure, or you can call this unit as a Pascal. So it is Newton per meter square into second. So Newton per meter square may be called as Pascal and into second. So it is Pascal second also. And this can be written as kg per meter second. One more unit is there in CGS system for the viscosity, that is poise. And this one poise is equal to 1 gram per centimeter second. And this is also equal to 100 centipoise. And from this, we can say that 1 Pascal second is equal to 10 poise. Typical values for the viscosity of water is 1.14 into 10 raised to minus 3 Pascal second, and for the air, it is 1.778 into 10 raised to minus 5 Pascal second. So we'll see the viscosity in detail. So consider there are two plates, one is fixed plate and other is moving plate, and the space between the two plates is filled with the help of water. And these green are the water molecules, and the moving plate is applied with a shear force F, and these are the layers of layer one liquid molecules. Layer one has certain molecules along it, while there is a layer two. Similarly, layer two has molecules along with this, and layer 1 is below the layer, sorry, layer 2 is below the layer 1, similarly layer 3, layer 4, 5, 6 and layer 7. So here layer 7 is closer to the fixed plate, and both these plates are separated by distance small b, and this is a xy coordinate, or you can say Cartesian coordinate. So along the plate the direction is x, while normal to the plates the direction is y. So once the shear force is applied on the moving plate, the moving plate will move in a forward direction towards right, and as there is a adherence of liquid layer 1 with a plate, so this property may be called as a viscosity, and because of this the layer 1 will attain a velocity of moving plate. So this is because of viscosity, and particularly it has a name, that is a no slip condition. So because of no slip condition, layer 1 will attain, that is closer to the moving plate, will attain the velocity of moving plate. Similarly there is a layer 7 which is closer to the fixed plate, again because of the viscosity there would be a no slip condition, and layer 7 will attain the viscosity of fixed plate. As the fixed plate velocity is 0, layer 7's velocity would be 0, while layer 1's velocity would be equal to the moving plate's velocity, and the velocity will vary between layer 1 to 7. So from layer 1 to 7 the velocity will go on decreasing, while from the fixed plate to the moving plate the velocity will go on increasing. So see, molecules near the moving plate get adhered with it and moves with the same velocity of plate. So at moving plate, so this is a moving plate, the layer 1 velocity would be, that is along with the plate, so whatever the velocity the plate will have, the same velocity the layer 1 will have. And what is the condition? So the distance, suppose if you put the coordinate system over here, so here y would be 0 and here the y is equal to b, so v is equal to u at y is equal to b. So b is a separation or spacing between the two plates at fixed plate, y is equal to 0, and the velocity of molecular layer 7 would be equal to the velocity of plate. So here as the plate is fixed, the molecular layer velocity of layer 7 would be 0. So here at layer 7 v is equal to 0, while y is equal to 0. So this condition where liquid layer and plate having same velocity, see the plate may be moving or the plate may be fixed, but the layers which are in touch with the boundary are having same velocity. So this condition where liquid layer and plate have same velocity is called as no slip condition. So there is no relative tangential velocity between the layer and plate. Now so consider these two layers, layer 2 and 3. So you will find that layer 2 will have more velocity than that of the layer 3. Why? Because the moving plate is having moving plate is having velocity u, and the layer near to it will have velocity small u, and similarly from the moving plate towards the fixed plate the velocity goes on decreasing, and the layer 3 is at more distance than that of the layer 2. So if you consider the layer 2 and 3 and are separated by a distance dy, and layer 3 is having velocity equal to u, and layer 2's velocity is quite greater than the layer 3 velocity, and it is nothing but u plus du. And see, at the layer 3 the distance from the fixed plate is y, so y is equal to y, and for the layer 2 the distance would be equal to this y distance plus dy. And at the fixed boundary v is equal to 0, at y is equal to 0, at the moving boundary u is equal to u and y is equal to b. Now if you take the variation of velocity normal to the plate that is in y direction, see these are the plates moving and fixed, and normal to this is a nothing but a y direction, and you will observe that the velocity is varying in y direction, not in the x direction. So for the layer 3, take example of layer 3, the velocity at this point is du. At this point, it is sorry, it is u. At this point, again it is u. At this point, again it is u. But if you go to the layer 2, this velocity u has changed to u plus du. So you can say that the velocity variation is in y direction only, or you can say it is always normal to the direction of flow. This is the direction of flow, and normal to this there is a variation in velocity. So if you take a velocity difference between the two layers, it is u plus du minus u, so it is du. And if you take a see the velocity gradient, this velocity gradient is nothing but difference between the velocities divided by difference between the distance from the fixed plate. So it is nothing but du, and this is nothing, difference is nothing but dy. So du upon dy is nothing but a velocity gradient. So if you see the velocity variation, it is always parabolic in nature, and at fixed plate the velocity would be zero, and at the moving plate the velocity would be more. So if you take this two layers, layer 2 and layer 3, will have a continuous acceleration and retardation between the molecules. Layer 2 molecules will try to accelerate the molecules in layer 3, while as the layer 3 molecules are having less velocity, will try to retard the molecules in layer 2. So this continuous acceleration and continuous retardation by the molecular layers causes to a viscosity. So based on this, Newton postulated that there would be a shear stress present between the layers, and this shear stress is nothing but the is directly proportional to the difference between the velocities of two layers. See, this layer 3 is having velocity du, while this layer 2 is having u plus du. If you take a difference, you will get du, and if we have to obtain a velocity gradient, we need to divide this velocity difference by a distance between the two layers, that is dy. So tau is directly proportional to the du upon dy, and this is also known as velocity gradient. So dy is the distance of separation of two layers, du is the difference in velocities. Du upon dy, the velocity gradient, also it is known as rate of shearing strain, or also it is known as shear strain or rate of deformation at a point in direction perpendicular to the direction of motion of layer. Hence, so based on this, you can say that as tau is directly proportional to du upon dy, so the proportionality constant over here is mu, and this mu is nothing but viscosity, or it is also called as dynamic or absolute viscosity. Also, there is a drag force present between the layers, and if we relate this drag force with a shear stress, you will get tau is equal to F upon A, where A refers to the contact surface area of layer with a plate, not the cross sectional area. It is a contact surface area of the liquid layer plate. With it. Now, if you rearrange this equation, tau is equal to mu into du upon dy, to obtain the unit of mu, you will get mu is equal to tau divided by du upon dy. And if you put the units of tau as force per area, that is newton per meter square, and du as it is nothing but velocity, that is meter per second, and dy as a distance, that is meter, and if you simplify this, you will get newton second per meter square. Here newton per meter square is nothing but a pascal, so the unit is pascal second, and tau is nothing but F upon A, where F refers to a drag or shear force, it is in newton, A refers to a contact area between the liquid and plate, and power required to drag the plate is nothing but F into a velocity of plate. Similarly for the shaft, F is a peripheral velocity, F into U, where U is a peripheral velocity. And one more term is there, that is a kinematic viscosity, and it is having importance in viscous and gravitational forces, where there is a large impact of it on the flow. So this kinematic viscosity is nothing but ratio of viscosity to the density, and its unit is meter square per second. So here in CGS system it is 1 cm² per second, and this 1 cm² per second is nothing but 1 stroke, and that is equal to 100 centistroke. Typical values for water: 1.14 × 10⁻⁶ meter square per second. For air it is 1.46 × 10⁻⁵ meter square per second. So what are the causes of viscosity? There are two factors which are responsible for the viscosity, that is the intermolecular force of cohesion, and second one is a molecular momentum exchange. So how this happens? So here you will find that there are molecules with certain velocities. Molecules are always moving with velocities. So there may be a collision between the molecules, and this collision may lead to the transfer of momentum from one molecule to the other molecule, and this molecular momentum transfer will lead to the retardation of fluid motion, and this causes a increase in viscosity. Also, intermolecular force of cohesion, molecular force of cohesion or molecular force of attraction will try to the molecules will try to attract the molecules, and because of this there is a limitation on the movement of molecules from one place to the another place, and this will lead to the increase in viscosity. Now for liquids, this molecular momentum is less significant than that of the forces of cohesion. So for liquids, this intermolecular force of cohesion is important, and this is only responsible for the viscosity of liquids. And for liquids, with increase in temperature, the viscosity decreases. For liquids, with increase in temperature, the viscosity decreases. While for the gases, the molecular motion is more and it is significant, and because of this, there is a molecular momentum transfer. See, as we heat the gas, what will happen? The velocity of molecules will increase, and there is more possibility of collision of molecules with each other if they are confined in a space, and that will transfer a momentum to each other, and that will lead to the increase in viscosity. So here the example of water is given. So if you go on heating the water from 0 degree Celsius to the 100 degree Celsius, its viscosity decreases from 180 to the in between 20 to 60. And for air, when you go on heating the air from 0 degree Celsius to the 100 degree Celsius, its viscosity will go on increasing, and that is because of increased molecular collisions. So one final point that is left in this viscosity is no slip condition of viscous fluids. So as it is mentioned over there, for no slip condition to exist, the liquid must be viscous. For ideal fluids, no slip condition does not exist. So it refers to the relative velocity between the solid surface and the adjacent fluid layer, and this relative velocity is zero whenever the viscous fluid flow over a solid surface. This is also known as a no slip condition. No slip condition exists for viscous fluids only. This behavior of no slip at solid surfaces, this behavior of no slip at the solid surface is not a surface tension. For example, mercury flowing in a stationary glass tube will not wet the surface, but will have a zero velocity at the wall of a tube. And this non-meeting property of mercury is nothing but a surface tension. So no slip condition is a consequence of fluid viscosity. So we should not make a confusion between surface tension and viscosity. So this is all for the viscosity. In the next class, we'll see the types of fluids based on the viscosity laws, that is Newton's law of viscosity, power law model, and then after we are going to see the numericals, application based numericals on the viscosity. Thank you. That's all.